Rev Norm.
Mr. Kool-Aid, how the heck are ya?
Hello, Derby World. This is John Kool-Aid Porter coming to you live from the Pershing Center with the lovely Rev Norb. We are here for Texas versus Omaha. Don't think we have time to do rosters. We'll get to those in a minute.
We assure you, each team is fielding a full roster of 14 skaters, and they're all most up and up.
Skaters already lined up. This is the number one seed, Texas Roller Girls, going against the number eight seed, Omaha Roller Girls, who defeated Tallahassee 201-42 earlier today. The winner of this game will be skating tomorrow at 2 p.m. against the Tampa Roller Girls. The loser will go into the loser's bracket, hoping to get up to fifth place. Let's see if we can get through these. Skating for Texas today, number 02, Shortcut. Number 03, Olivia Shootin' John. Number 1600, Barbara Ambush. Number 1853, Vicious Van Gogo. Number 1889, Belle Star. Number 19, Molotov Impale. Number 222, Desecration. Number 30, Bloody Mary. Number 33, Loose Bandit. Number 5, Smarty Pants. Number 76, Curvette. Number 77, Centerfold. Number 86, The Killa Salmonella. And number 989, Juice Box.
And for the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars, wearing the white and the black numerals and the red trim, we've got number 101, Sharon Misery. Number 2, Makilia. Number 215 is Bellicose. Number 39 is Midlife Crashes. 402 is Make It Rain. 42 is Axel Rogue. Wearing the same number as Herbie the Love Bug. Number 53, that's I'm a Firestarter. We've got 665, Daisy Mayhem. 6 foot is Danielle in your coffin. 777 is Rady Ruck. 964 is E-Blastigirl. 999 is Anna Maniac. F5 is Anti-Embolism, and rounding out the roster for the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars is MK80, Molly Massacre.
I would like to correct one skater for Texas. Number 989 is not my daughter, Juicebox, but in fact, Killbox. My mistake. All right, 5 seconds from the start of the action. Looks like we've got number 33, Loose Bandit on the, 03, Olivia Shootin' John on the jammer line for Texas.
And with Omaha, we have got number 999, Anna Maniac. She is on and off the jammer line. She has been dispensed to the back of the pack and is attempting to pierce that rear wall of Texas Black. Meanwhile, we have got Omaha controlling the... And through, we have a lead jammer. That is number 03 for Texas. That is Olivia Shootin' John.
And a maniac trying to get up front. She does. Pushes off the hit from Barbara Ambrose. Here is Olivia Shootin' John now on a scoring pass. Solid defense by Omaha. OJ squirts around on the outside and calls it off. Picked up 3 points.
Nice work, Maniac, able to force a early call off of the jam before all 4 points are awarded to the Texas Roller Girls. Therefore, our score after one jam, 3-0 in favor of Texas over Omaha at the all-important 29-minute and 5-second mark of the first period.
And coming out of the jammer line for Omaha in the white, I'm a fire starter for Texas in the black, Vicious Van Gogo.
Vicious Van Gogo, a former Dairyland doll.
That is correct. Scrum start to begin with. Vicious pushing towards the front. I'm a fire starter, not far behind her. Vicious looks for the outside line. She's got it. Lee jammer. Vicious Van Gogo. I'm a fire starter. Shrugs off a hit. She's out as well. About 30 feet separate the jammers.
Yep, I'm a fire starter tail of the tent, and we shall see how much Vicious Van Gogo can accrue here. She hits the pack. She goes through right, goes through left, falls off from a supine position.
But not before I'm a Firestarter with a nice apex jump right at the end at turn one, able to score 2 points. Both jammers got 2 points in the jam.
That makes everything look like Richard Nixon giving double peace signs. On the jammer line with the score now 5-2 in favor of Texas, we have got in the white and the red trim, that is number 39, Midlife Crashes for the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars.
And number 989, Killbox, comes to the jammer line for Texas. 5-on-5 as the penalty box is empty. Another scrum start to begin.
And we've got a lot of left and right lateral motion. No clear victor emerging yet as they round turn two.
Midlife Crashes is now up front with the Texas defense. Killbox comes around on the outside. Killbox lead jammer for Texas. Midlife Crashes is forced to the outside. She recycles all the way to the back.
That might be the Texas's first chance to get a full four-point scoring pass in, as Omaha is rather beleaguered right now by a mighty two-wall up in front by seasoned veterans Bloody Mary and Killbox.
Killbox now finishes her scoring pass. Midlife Crashes going to the penalty box for a major track cut. So this is a power jam now for Texas. A minute 13 seconds left in this jam. Killbox jamming all by herself. Texas opens a hole. Killbox comes through for a shave and a haircut. 5 points.
That's a five-point grand slam worth 5 points. That's what that is, and that's the best kind.
Packet, a complete stop at turn three. Here comes Killbox again. Comes through, knocked down, back up. No call by the refs. Good no call. Pack starts to move now, but Texas has a goat in the back. Out of play, and Killbox is through for another pentapass, a five-point scoring pass.
Texas looking to make hay while the sun shines right now. I think if they can put up a sizable lead on Omaha early, they might put Omaha, you know, they might put this out of Omaha's reach right quick. I don't see Omaha coming back on Texas if they allow Texas to, you know, pile up a bunch of points before halftime. That's another 5 points. That is another grand slam for number 989, Killbox, for the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners.
Midlife Crash is standing in the penalty box. Killbox here for another grand slam. That is 25 points now in this jam. And Killbox sees Midlife Crash is standing, calls it off. You can see the frustration on her face. Looked like she was hoping to call it off in time to extend the power jam into the next jam. Instead, she essentially deprived herself of a free scoring pass. But be that as it may, now 30-2, Texas over Omaha with 25 minutes left in this first half.
Yeah, that's going to bring the jammer numbers back to one apiece for each team. However, Omaha's going to start this one out. It looks like both teams are going to start with the blocker of the box. No, I correct myself. Don't listen to anything I say. I'm a nut.
All right, we've got a Blasted Girl versus Smarty Pants, and Smarty Pants is through before she even got to the payment line. Lead jammer for Texas.
That, if I don't miss my guess, is the fourth straight lead jammer for Texas.
It is
4-0.
And Smarty Pants work. There's the jammer lap point. She's around. Picked up all 5 points. The Blaster Girl still trying to get out of her initial pass, having no luck with Texas defense. All four blockers on the track.
Texas doing a real nice job of controlling the front of the pack with just two blockers in the front generally. They can use those other blockers in the back to agitate the Omaha blockers.
And just as we say, Blaster Girl is out. Smarty Pants sees her. Not sure if she picked up any point. 2 points on that last pass. One for the blocker she passed, one for the blocker in the box.
So at the all-important 24 minutes and 40-second mark of the first period, it is 37-2 in favor of Texas. Back on that jammer line for Omaha, one of my favorite English 70s punk bands, numbers 999. That is Animaniac for the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars. And on that jammer line for Texas, whom do we have? Kool-Aid.
One of my favorite morning beverages, Olivia Shootin' John, or OJ, as we call her in Texas. OJ pushes away to the outside, knocked out of bounds. Comes quickly back in. Pack starts to speed up. Olivia Shootin' John is out. OJ, lead jammer for Texas. Animaniac, meanwhile, still coming around turn two in the back of the pack.
Once again, Texas using a pretty sparse front wall to absolutely control the pack. They have got jammers in the back. They've got, blockers in the back, blockers in the front.
OJ comes in on a scoring pass around. OJ pauses just a minute to see if Animaniac was going to clear the pack. I suspect OJ was going to recycle her if given the opportunity, but the Texas defense does not allow Animaniac out. So that's one grand slam for OJ. Comes now on her second scoring pass. As Animaniac gets up front, and Animaniac does get out. OJ catches up to her. We'll see what she does here. That was 4 points on that last pass. Neither team has any blockers in the penalty box right now, Norv.
They do not, and that's a good thing. Looks like Olivia Shootin' John was the tail of the tandem on the blockers, as opposed to doing any sort of jiggery-pokery where she attempted to get that jammer lap point. She calls it off as she was just parsec, mini parsecs. Parsec's pretty long. I shouldn't even say that. Anyway, never mind that. 46-2 is our score. 23 minutes is our time. Texas in the black, Omaha in the white.
And we've got Vicious Van Gogh jamming for Texas versus, for the first time tonight, Rady Ruck for Omaha.
Rady Ruck wearing the 777. 1853 is the number of Vicious Van Gogh. Didn't sleep much last night, Kool-Aid. Please forgive my digressions.
All right, and Vicious comes around. She is lead jammer. Rady Ruck going to the penalty box for a major back block. Second power jam for Texas. Vicious does have lead jammer. Status comes down to a four wall of Omaha. Texas now stops the non-skating passive offense, clears Vicious's way. She's out for a five-point grand slam.
Worth 5 points. Omaha cannot weather too many big jams like this against Texas. Texas starts piling on points by 5s and 10s and 15s and 20s. They're going to be sending their settles home right quick. Luckily, they live nearby. So we have got molecular agitation in the pack. And Vicious Van Gogh go through. I believe that is another five-point scoring pass, otherwise known as a grand slam.
Grady Ruck should be out. Oh, nice ape. Well, nice attempt at an apex jump by Vicious.
She didn't really stick the dismount.
She did not stick the dismount. Avoided the track cut penalty by staying down as she came back into the inbounds area. And Grady Ruck is standing.
That's another 5 points for Vicious Van Gogh. That wasn't as bad as it could have been if you are an Omaha fan.
Well, I think the Vicious failing to stick the landing there definitely prevented the at least one more scoring pass, as Vicious called it off in time to extend the power jam into the waning, or the first few seconds of this next jam. As we line up 61-2 with 21 minutes left in this first half, Texas over Omaha. Killbox comes to the jammer line for Texas. Again, Grady Ruck in the penalty box, but standing.
And we have staunch defense right there by Omaha. They got her in a modified Malachi crunch from which she's sprung.
Killbox now up front, and she's out of play. Killbox is through for lead jammer. Grady Ruck working. Oh, there was a jammer star pass, number 53. Right. I'm a fire starter.
Huzzah. Oh, exciting. And the crowd goes wild.
As Killbox with an incredibly acrobatic move there to stay in bounds. Solid hit by Omaha, but Killbox able to skate on one skate just on the right side of the out-of-bounds line. Calls off the jam, scoring 4 more points for Texas.
And that's going to make the score 65-2 with just seconds over 20 minutes to go in the first period of the fifth game of the first day of the Southern Regional Women's Flat Track Derby Association Championship Tournament.
All right, we've got Smarty Pants coming back to the jammer line for Texas.
And for Omaha, we have got number 39, Midlife Crashes. She's wearing number 39. I said that twice.
Midlife Crashes did go to the penalty box last time she was out there wearing the jammer star. We'll see if she can improve on that. Midlife Crashes is up front. Smarty Pants in the back. Formidable Texas defense holding on to Midlife Crashes now. One to beat, past Molotov and Pale. Midlife Crashes is through for the first lead jammer for Omaha of the game.
There was a tremendous pancaking hit on Smarty Pants that unceremoniously deposited her at the cusp of turn three. That allowed Omaha to get their first lead jammer of the evening.
Smarty Pants does get out. Texas has got an incredibly fast pack moving forward. Here's Midlife Crashes now into the pack.
Looks like Omaha will be down a blocker. Sharon Misery heading to the penalty box. Did not see the infraction.
And calling it off as Smarty Pants came up. 2 points for Omaha. Doubles their score to 4.
Texas lobbying for 1 point. They shall not get that. 65 to 4 shall be our score at 18:53 in the first period.
But if you want to score points, you should get some Rydell skates, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, Rydell skates. Find them on the web at RydellSkates.com.
If you get them in two different colors, you can have unmatched skates as well. Back on the jammer line for Omaha, we've got number 999. That is Animaniac. Yes, she's Animaniac. She looks like she's going up against number 03. That is Olivia Shootin' John for the Texecutioners in
and
the black.
OJ, or as we like to call Olivia Shootin' John, is quickly through for lead jammer.
Olivia Shootin' John was lead jammer before I could actually announce her name and the fact that she was jamming.
There's the jammer lap point. There's all 5 points. Grand slam for OJ.
And it looks like McKillia will be taking a seat in the penalty box for the Omaha Roller Girls. That will contribute to their early miseries here. Got a lot of slaloming and a lot of game hitting by the blockers, but Olivia Shootin' John threw again another four fingers and a thumb. That is another 5 points for the Texas Roller Girls. Texas right now controlling the front of the pack. Whoa, but around and through. That is number 999 for Omaha. Animaniac is off. She is through on her scoring pass, but she shall not score. That's 4 more points for Texas, and our score looks like 79-4 in favor of the Texas Roller Girls.
Norb, that was a solid play by Animaniac at the close of that jam. Paused a minute, played some defense on OJ, held her back just long enough that for the door to open for Animaniac, which was then able to quickly get through, forcing the call-off by OJ. So, solid play there by the Omaha Roller Girls.
Huzzah.
Huzzah.
For the first time tonight, I believe we are seeing number 964 Eblastigirl on the general line for the Omaha.
Oh, but Vicious Van Gogh, not for the first time tonight, is Lee Jammer.
Vicious Van Gogh had a tremendous Southern Regionals tournament last year, IMO, and tremendous championships as well.
There's the Jammer lap point. Vicious now shrugs off a hit. She's through for another five-point grand slam.
We are not seeing Texas being plagued by those slow starts that plague some of the other higher seeds in the other tournaments for the last 3 weeks. They are coming out of the gate rather loaded for bear, as the kids say.
Texas is doing a solid job on Eblastigirl. She, again, is still working on her initial pass. That's another grand slam for Vicious Van Gogh. Still 5-on-5. We've seen surprisingly few trips to the box, Norm.
We haven't. That's
because... Oh, and that is going to be called major low block on Vicious. Power jam now for midlife crashes.
Way to jinx the clean play, Kool-Aid. Anyway, time for Omaha to cut that deficit or at least make a gosh darn great run at it. There is a four wall up in front for Texas.
Eblastigirl trying to get through. Omaha moves a couple of blockers forward to engage the Texas pack. Texas wall, I should say. Pack moving fairly slow. A solid hit by Desecration on Eblastigirl forces her out. Eblastigirl working her way up towards the front.
Looks like she was nudged out of bounds, and she's going to have to re-enter at the back of the pack as far as I can tell from my vantage point.
That is correct. That was a loose bandit with a hit on Eblastigirl to force her out. This penalty has about 20 seconds left in it in the power jam. The jam, though, will end shortly. Clock ticks down to zero. That was 5 points for Eblastigirl.
And that's going to take our score to 89-9 in favor of the Texas Roller Girls. Omaha putting up, as you said, five big American points. 14:49 to go in the first period.
So with Vicious in the penalty box with, again, about 15 seconds left, I believe, left on this power jam.
I'm a fire starter. Will be jamming unopposed. You may recall her as the recipient of the star pass in a previous jam.
Omaha and sends a blocker to the penalty box on an intentional fourth minor. Interesting choice when they already had one in the box. Texas with all four of their blockers in. Texas with a slow start there. That does spring Vicious Van Gogh. Both jammers skating. Both jammers eligible for lead jammer. Vicious through. Vicious Van Gogh. Lead jammer with a second jam in a row. I'm a fire starter up front. Shrugs off a hit for Barbara Ambush, and she's out. About 60 feet separate these jammers as Vicious approaches the pack.
Vicious has only got two blockers in there. She is going to rack up 4 points for passing two. Pretty difficult to put the wood to Vicious Van Gogh when there's two of you and there's four of the opponents. Anyway, that's going to be four more points for, would that be five more points for Texas?
Four.
I can't see fingers. Very well.
89-4 is 93.
The devil, you say. 13:31 to go in the first period. 93-9 is, in fact, our score. Back on that jammer line for Omaha. That is number 777, Rady Ruck, in the white with the black numerals. For the Omaha Roller Girls, she's going up against Killbox in the black with the white numerals and the red trim for the Texecutioners.
And Killbox, with a nice juke at turn one. She's out for lead jammer. Killbox for the Texas Roller Girls. Rady Ruck, meanwhile, still in the pack. Here comes Killbox to begin a scoring pass, Norb.
Killbox juked me out of my seat, and I'm, 68 yards away from her. So that was a quality maneuver. Anyway, that looks like another five-point grand slam worth 5 points for Killbox and the Texas Roller Girls.
Untouched on that pass was Killbox. That brings her total to 34 points for this game thus far. She is the high scorer for Texas. Rady Ruck does a nice job, gets out. Killbox looks like she wants that fifth point.
Rady Ruck not moving real quickly.
Killbox wanted to get that point and lay a hit on Rady Ruck. Looks like Killbox is engaging the pack. Hits it, quits it. No points for Omaha. Five more points on that scoring pass.
I believe if Bret Hart was here, he'd call it the excellence of execution. Called off in the nick of time. No points for Rady Ruck. Five more points for Texas. 107-9 is our score in favor of the Texas Roller Girls. 12 minutes, 7 seconds. Time left in the first period. Back on that jammer line for Omaha. We have got number 39, Midlife Crashes. In the white with the red leggings and red numerals. And she is going up against, that's number 5, Smarty Pants 4. The Texecutioners in the black with the white numerals. And she is unceremoniously deposited at turn 1.
Molly Massacre with a solid hit there on Smarty Pants Norb. But Smarty Pants gets up. Texas defense hold. Midlife Crashes. Smarty Pants out for lead jammer.
Swell recovery.
That was a pretty impressive hit by Molly Massacre.
Fine play all around. Huzzah for everyone.
Here comes Smarty Pants now into the pack on a scoring pass. Gets the jammer lap point and picked up off. 5 points.
Midlife Crashes having a bit of a midlife crisis right now. She is beleaguered by varying between 3 and 4 Texas defenders, depending on the time of the jam and the time of day.
Smarty Pants with a nice cut through the pack, untouched, and she picks up another 5 points.
Texas looking to put this one away early. Looks like the pivot for Texas, that is number 1600, Barbara Ambush. She will be taking a seat in the penalty box.
Speaking of pivots, we just had a jammer star pass to, I believe, Animaniac. Yes, Animaniac is now the jammer for Omaha.
However, such shenanigans are not paying off at the pay window, because number 5 for the Texas Roller Girls, Smarty Pants, has scored her jersey number, which is in fact 5 points.
And Animaniac does finally get the jammer cover on. Looks like Smarty Pants looked back, saw where Animaniac was, and called it off quickly. You know, folks, if you're tired of sliding through slippery corners, and I know I am, try the new Radar Villain Wheel. You can find Radar Wheels on their website at www.radarwheels.com.
Radar Wheels. Anyway, back on the jammer line for Omaha. Never mind the golden earring references. That is number 53. I'm a fire starter in the white with the red leggings. She's going up against number 03, Olivia Shootin' John, in the black with the white numerals and the red star of the Texas Roller Girls. I'm a fire starter dashing left and right like she's trying to find an open stall at the Quick Trip bathroom, but it is lead jammer awarded to number 03, Olivia Shootin' John, for the Texecutioners.
I'm a fire starter, though. Shrugs off the hit on the outside line. She is out. Here comes OJ now on a scoring pass. Looks like she picked up, I believe, 3 points. Yes, 3 points for OJ. Thus far, Nora, we've got 14 jams in the book. As looks like we've got a timeout on the part of Omaha. 14 jams thus far. 13 of the lead jammers have been from Texas.
That seems to indicate a clear proclivity towards Texas receiving lead jammer in this boat. That's why I'm reading it.
You know, and I know some folks who have shown some clear proclivities towards supporting WFTDA.TV. We'd like to thank the following WFTDA.TV partners: Blood and Thunder Magazine, Derbyology, Derby for Life, Derby for All, Derbalife, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Skate Shop, Jammer Up, and Wicked Skatewear.
Heck, I'd like to thank the Nation of Tuvalu for licensing all domains that end in .tv. It's true. Nobody would make up something that stupid. In case you're keeping track at home, folks, it is 129-9, just in case you are within the sound of our voice, but not within the sound of our face. That didn't make any sense. Anyway, we've got 9 minutes to go and change.
I think what you were trying to say, Norb, was you were trying to encourage everyone that if you're just listening on the audio-only feed, go ahead and upgrade. Again, it's only $12, which had you bought it this morning would average out to 70 cents a game. It's still pretty cheap at the end of the day.
I'm pretty cheap at the end of the day, and I was actually more than happy to fork out my $12 for the last few weekends.
$12 gets you the entire weekend in high quality.
If you're unemployed, don't worry about it. Just sit on the couch for 3 days, watch roller derby, tell them Norb said it's all right, have them waive your work search, look for a job on Monday. You need your computer for more important things until Monday.
We're back. Vicious Van Gogh versus Animaniac. Vicious up front, pushing that remaining blocker for Omaha is Vicious. Is around. She's lead jammer, Vicious Van Gogh for Texas.
Animaniac was pinned by a staunch three wall. She is now through, but she is the tail of the tandem. She is about 40% of a revolution behind her opposite number for Texas.
Vicious now begins her scoring pass. And a Maniac coming in quick. Vicious does call it off, I believe, in time.
Yeah, Vicious was knocked a little bit wide. That forced her to call it perhaps a little bit earlier than she had intended.
Quick zebra huddle at turn three. 3 points for Texas in that last jam.
135-9, Shelby, our score at the all-important 8 minute and 18-second mark of the first period. Back on the jammer line, number 53, I'm a fire starter for the Omaha Roller Girls in the white with the black numerals and the red leggings. She's going up against in the black and the white numerals with the red star, Killbot.
I'm a fire starter. It's her fifth jam, wearing the jammer star for Omaha. And she is out, lead jammer. I'm a fire starter for the Omaha Roller Girls. And not surprisingly, the crowd just went pretty wild, Norb.
The crowd's going berserk. Berserk, I tell you. Wish you were here. You could get me some more cough drops and animal crackers.
4 points there for Omaha. That's got to feel good. That's got to feel really, really good for the Omaha Roller Girls. I don't think you have any serious aspirations as the outcome of this game, but it's got to feel good. Get lead jammer status, score 4 points, get a good solid jam under your belt.
Plus, it's four unanswered points, so it's not like you're doing tit for tat and so on and so forth. So, you know, huzzah for that. Go Omaha, go. 132-13 is our score. 7-11 is our time remaining in the first period. On that jammer line for the Omaha Roller Girls, number 964.
The Blastagirl. And Smarty Pants on the jammer line, wearing number 5 for Texas. Good defense by both teams. Smarty Pants is up, though, as there was a brief no pack call to allow her out. She is lead jammer for Texas.
Man, Pack Eddie stands still. Now the Pack gets sort of unstoppered. The Blastagirl's got one to beat before she gets out of that pack, but it is all in vain because Smarty Pants, number 5, is through. She has passed her. She has got another 5-point grand slam worth 5 points for the Texas Roller Girls.
The Blastagirl still trying to get out. The Texas defense not letting her through. Here is Smarty Pants on her second scoring pass. Comes around untouched on the outside. The door was wide open, and that's another grand slam.
There was a real nice hit from Bell Starr that put the Omaha jammer in the infield between the turns 3 and 4 that allowed that most recent grand slam to occur.
And again, the outside line is open. Smarty Pants untouched for 5 more points.
Drew the pack cleaner than Paul McCartney's grandfather.
So a blast.
Anyway, pack sort of comes to a mild standstill on turn 2. Now they begin to animate again. Bell Star with some fancy footwork. The Blastagirl rather be calm behind a sea of black.
Blastagirl does finally get out to a nice round of cheering from the audience, but Smarty Pants this time on the inside line comes through and called off. And Rep Norb, I have to ask you, just how clean is Paul McCartney's grandfather?
According to the dialogue in Hard Day's Night, he's very clean. Very clean. He's also a mixer. He's a mixer. A king mixer. 152-13 is our score with 5 minutes and 8 seconds left in the first period. Back on the jammer line for the Omaha Roller Girls in the white with the black numerals. It is number 999. She is an Animaniac.
You know, it is time for Animaniac to get lead jammer. Going up against OJ, Olivia Shootin' John for Texas. Oh, Animaniac around on the outside. Opa! As Animaniac is lead jammer. 30 feet behind her, though, is OJ. Both jammers skating full speed. Texas has all three of their blockers in the back. Animatic cuts around, calls it off. Did she pass him in bounds? Look to the outside jam ref for clarification. Quick zebra huddle. If she was in bounds, it's good. Well, 1 point. 1 point for Animaniac on that pass.
That was a lot of fast skating for 1 point. Looks like Loose Bandit went to the penalty box and all the consternation and hubbub. That will put Texas at a blocker disadvantage. Back on the jammer line for the Texas Roller Girls, number 1853. That is Vicious Van Gogh. She's going up against number 39 in the white with the red numerals for the Omaha Roller Girls. That's Midlife Crashes.
152-15 with 4 minutes left in the first half. The jam has begun, I promise you. Both teams with 3 blockers on the track. It would appear they're both earning some penalty time. Jammers are released as the last blocker crossed the pivot line. Nice hit by Bloody Mary to force the midlife crashes out of bounds and back to the back. Meanwhile, Vicious up front, out. Lead jammer for Vicious Van Gogh.
Oh, mighty keeper of the stats. How many lead jammer? Never mind that. It is out in the back on her scoring pass, number 39, midlife crashes. I don't know how many lead jammer statuses Vicious Van Gogh has gotten yet tonight, but someone will tell me. And she calls it off. She has gotten, I believe that is 4 points for Texas as to 0 points for Omaha.
That is the sixth jam which Vicious has gotten lead jammer. Oddly enough, all of the jams in which Vicious has appeared, she's gotten lead jammer, even the time where she went to the penalty box, came out of the penalty box in the next jam, and got lead jammer yet again.
She's got a future in this roller derby thing. 156-15 is our score in favor of Texas, the number one seed going into the tournament. 2:48 is our time left in the first period. Once again, back on the jammer line, and now off the jammer line, number 53, I'm a fire starter for the Omaha Roller Girls. She's going up against Killbox. Killbox out, Killbox through. Killbox lead jammer for the Texas Roller Girls. Both teams regaining their blockers. They shall have a full complement of humanity. I'm a fire starter out on her scoring pass, but she is almost a full half rotation behind Killbox. However, Killbox not paying all that much attention to I'm a fire starter, who is making her way through the pack. Now there is no pack.
I'm a fire starter forced to the interior. She has to recycle all the way back.
Grand slam scored by Killbox.
4 points by I'm a fire starter.
At this point in time, I don't believe Texas is going to be playing things too closely to the vest. I think they're just going to skate around. Well, I beg your pardon.
Killbox, with one of the more athletic moves I've seen her do as she came into turn one, did an amazing lateral move from the outside to the inside as she spun around in a clockwise direction, able to completely juke the blockers out of their skates. Very nice athletic move by Killbox.
I am frightened. I am frightened at her athleticism. I think I'm going to go crawl under the table and nap in fright. 1:24 left in the period clock. 169-19 is our score. An evil and even sesquicentennial 150-point lead for Texas.
And Animaniac jamming for Omaha is out. She's lead jammer, forced out of bounds, though, just as she was about to completely eclipse the pack. Comes all the way back to the back. Now out of the pack is Smarty Pants. She is the jammer in the lead, but not the lead jammer. Nice hit by Killa Salmonella. And Animaniac says, enough of this.
Yeah, it almost looked like the foremost two wall of Texas was going to be lured out of play and have to relinquish the reins of terror on Omaha, but that did not happen. They called it a wash. 169-19 is our score. This is very likely, unless Martians rain havoc from the sky, the last jam in the period. And back on the jammer line, how fitting, we have got number 53. I'm a fire starter for Omaha Roller Girls. She's going up against number 03, Olivia Shootin' John, for the Texas Roller Girls.
I'm a fire starter is the point leader for Omaha. Looks like we had an illegal procedure false start minor on OJ as she did yielded advantage to I'm a fire starter. I'm a fire starter is out. She is not lead jammer. Looks like a minor back block. OJ is lead. She calls it off. 6 seconds left. Does Texas call timeout to get one more jam in, or do they just let it go?
It appears that they let it go.
And that is the jam. That is the half.
Well, a quickly moving half, if nothing else.
Exactly. So Texas doing, I think, pretty much what we expected them to do. 169-19 is the score. Remember, the winner of this game is going to be playing at 2 p.m. tomorrow against Tampa Roller Derby. Norm, what does Omaha do in the second half? What would your strategy, you think, be as you come in facing a 150-point deficit?
Well, at this point in time, I couldn't actually tell you what exact strategical, jiggery-pokery has to go on. But as far as, the high-level kind of thing, what I like to see as a fan when you're watching a game and it's halftime, and it's obviously one team is well in control and the other team is, it's probably not going to be their day. I just kind of like to hope that I can see them both play even. I wouldn't worry about making up 150 points on Texas. I'm largely certain that that's not going to happen. Play it even. See if you can play them even. If you can, you can. If you can't, you can't. There's no reason for Omaha to get down, obviously. you know, this is going to be the worst that they're going to be beaten all weekend if they, you know, get beaten again. They're not going to be playing the number one seed again. They're not going to be, you know.
Well, you know, I think Omaha has to feel pretty good about themselves. The last 2 years they've in regional tournament play, they played in the ninth place game, lost it 1 year, won it 1 year. So they finished ninth and tenth the last 2 years in this tournament. This year, guaranteed no worse than eighth, and you have to think that they come into the second half looking to see what we can improve on, how we can get ready for our next game, because that's really going to be the big determinant. Can we win our next game and get ourselves in line to play for fifth, or are we going to end up in the seventh place game?
Yeah, I mean, Omaha, they, by golly, they've got bright futures ahead of them, and they're the only team I can think that have played in both the North Central and South Central regional tournaments.
All right, and we are back. Again, this is John Kool-Aid Porter, joined here by...
I believe I'm Reverend Norb.
So, second half of tonight's festivities, Texas 169, Omaha 19. The winner will go on tomorrow at 2 p.m. to play Tampa. The loser will go tomorrow morning at...
Yes, I realize I need bifocals. I don't have enough money for a new pair of glasses. You figure that one out.
They've done this ahead of time. Well, we'll figure it out in a bit.
Yeah, so, high standards of professionalism. That's what we're all about.
Point scores in the first half, no surprise. Texas has several players in double digits. Killbox, the point leader for Texas, with 56 points. Smarty Pants not too far behind her with 46. Vicious Van Gogh at 38. And surprisingly, Olivia Shute and John only 29 points for Texas, but we've also seen her out there blocking a number of occasions. She will go back-to-back on any number of jams. Lead point scorer for Omaha is I'm a Firestarter at 10 points. With three other folks who've scored points for Omaha. Blastgirl at 5, Animaniac at 2, and Midlife Crashes at 2.
And yeah, that all up, it is 169-19. Danged if it's not.
Good time to thank the following WFTDA South Central Region playoff partners. Big thanks to Blood and Thunder Magazine, Bones Bearings, Bont Skates, Cruise Skate Shop, Derby for All, Derby Love, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Magazine, Print Co., Sin City, Sisu Mouth Guards, Vanilla Skates, Viva Las Vegas, Wicked Skatewear. And again, that was Five Stride Skate Shop and 515mag.com.
The Five Savage. And back on the jammer line is the high point scorer for Omaha thus far. That's number 53. That's I'm a Firestarter.
And joining her is OJ, Olivia Shute and John for Texas. One Texas blocker in the box. All four on the track for Omaha.
Omaha starts on a knee. Olivia Shute and John trying to blast through a two wall on the inside. She has got one human to beat. She has beaten that human. Lead jammer for Texas. That is number 03, Olivia Shute and John.
I'm a Firestarter, though. It's a nice move. Does get out. Quick moving pack. OJ comes towards the front. Able to shrug off a hit. Stays in bounds. Calls it off. Four more points for Texas.
She squished through that pack like sort of a wet bar of soap in a fist. I think it's rather hard to sort of, you know, gum up the works when you've got somebody so elusive and lugubrious, is that the word I'm looking for? I don't know. 173-19 is our score. 29-14 is the time after the first jam of the second period of the fifth game of the first day of the landlocked lace-up. Back on the jammer line for Omaha in the white. That is number 999. That is Animaniac. She's going up against number 1853 for Texas. That's Vicious Van Gogh.
Oh, solid defense by Omaha, forcing Vicious out, but she comes quickly back in, avoids a track cut, comes around on the outside for lead jammer.
Vicious very variable in her approach. She was trying real hard to pierce the inside for a few seconds. That didn't go so well. She hopped over to the right side, came in on the outside, thus lead jammer for Texas, as you stated. Oh, nice hit by Daisy Mayhem. Number 665 for Omaha. She puts Vicious
Put Vicious down to the ground, and really, after that hit with Animaniac closing quickly, Vicious just called it off. That hit right there saved a point for Omaha. Just a solid hit.
It was like one of those hits you see in a bar fight where there's not a whole lot of swinging, but you can tell it really hurt because it didn't look like much, but then the person went down really hard and violently.
And more to the point, stayed there for just a minute.
And stayed there and thought about what they had done. Back on the jammer line for The Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars in the white. That is number 964, and that is Eblastigirl. She's going up against number on and off. I believe that's 989. Killbox in the black for the Texas Roller Girls.
That is correct, and Killbox does finally get through, working really hard, but she's out for lead jammer. Eblastigirl makes her way towards the front.
Looks like Bellstar will be taking a seat.
And shrugging off a hit is Eblastigirl. She's out of the pack. Here's Killbox on a scoring pass, completes it, checks the position of Eblastigirl, and calls it off.
Very tidy 4-0 for Texas, and the second jam of the second period of Game 5 here. 180-19 appears to be our new score. 27-21 appears to be our time remaining.
All right, and jamming for the first time tonight for Texas is number 19, Molotov Impale.
And she's going up against number 39. That is Midlife Crashes for the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars. Omaha will be starting this one out on a knee just in front of the jammer line.
You can hear the Texas jammer for Rinkster, Texas tracker for Rinkster going, wait a minute, where's 19?
It's the old bait and switch, I tell you.
All right, both jammers working their way towards the front. Molotov Impale, though, gets up. She is not lead jammer. Had a minor track cut, so Midlife Crashes still available. She's out. She's lead jammer as Midlife Crashes. Does she call it? Her bench says yes, emphatically called off, and she does. So jam win there for Omaha. Didn't score any points, but solid work there by Midlife Crashes to finish the pass. Got lead jammer and able to call it off, prevent Texas from scoring any points.
Fans of the Wacky Races cartoon show call that a double zero, a Dick Dastardly. 180-19 remains our score. 26-18 is our time remaining in the game.
Hanna-Barbera's racist?
What?
Hanna-Barbera's racist?
Wacky Races.
Races.
Yeah, Wacky Racist. Yeah, it's a sort of a adult adaptation of the classic late 1960s race cartoon. Anyway, enough airy persiflage. Out and through, and lead jammer for Texas. That appears to be number 03, Olivia Shootin' John, the jammer who is now out for Omaha, but not lead jammer. Once again, it is I'm a Fire Starter, number 53.
OJ now on a scoring pass, coming in very quickly and around. Checks where I'm a Fire Starter is not calling it off.
Daisy Mayhem taking a seat for Omaha blockers. Oh, looks like Texas is actually outnumbered in blockers.
I suspect that's a reason why OJ is not calling it off here. Nice hit by I'm a Fire Starter on OJ. Thought about going back, does not. Again, I believe Texas is trying to run some penalty clock here.
Looks like Texas has got all their bodies back on the track, but not for long. It looks like Desecration is headed to the penalty box.
I believe it was a direction of gameplay major. We'll have to check that later. Meanwhile, I'm a Fire Starter working, trying to get out. Here comes OJ again on another scoring pass. So not calling it off, paying off here for Texas. As that's 5 points, a pentapass for OJ.
The pentapass. And 4 points for I'm a Fire Starter for a savings of 1 point for Texas.
OJ in for another scoring pass, does finally call it off. 3 more points there for Texas. So some movement on the Omaha side, as it's now 197-23 with 25 minutes left in the game.
Back on that jammer line for the umpteenth time for Omaha. That is number 999, Animaniac. I guess I could actually look at the Rinkster and tell you exactly how many times that actually is.
11 jams where she's been out. Meanwhile, Vicious Van Gogh comes out for her 8th jam, having scored 41 points for Texas. Scrum start to start. Animaniac's on the outside. She's through. Animaniac, lead jammer for the Omaha Roller Girls.
Omaha defense doing a real nice job keeping the Texas jammer up penned up.
Vicious does just now get out, but here comes Anna on a scoring pass. Forced out of bounds, comes way back. Here comes Vicious. Anna quick calls it off. 4 points for Omaha. Really solid jam there by Omaha. Is able to get lead jammer, able to hold Vicious long enough to make that lead jammer worth something. And Texas calls a timeout.
Texas on the ropes. 23-33 left in the second period. 197-27 is our score. Yeah, I mean, if you're Omaha, you take your small your victories where you can get them. Do you have something to tell me, Kool-Aid?
I do. If you want to be a victor, you need to get yourself some Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. Find them on the web at adamwheels.com. Also, some fabulous gear. Green Monster, makers of Antic, Gumball Toe Stops, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. Green Monster doesn't just give you great derby products, they give you confidence. Find them on the web at Green Monster, that's Green Monster without the vowels, .com.
Don't spend your money buying vowels from Wheel of Fortune. They're expensive. Buy skate products from Green Monster.
But if you want to get some vowels printed up on a piece of paper, you could do so with PrintCo. For your league's printing and promotional needs, hit up PrintCoGraphics.com.
Thank you. And when decorum resumes, we're going to have number 39 for the Omaha Roller Girls. That is Midlife Crashes. She's going to be your jammer. And everybody, she's going to be going up against number 989, Killbox, in the black and the red for the Texas Roller Girls.
Omaha with all four of their blockers on the track. Texas with three, one standing in the penalty box. So we should be 5-on-5 here shortly. Killbox again has scored 60 points thus far in this game.
That's a fair amount of points. A hush comes over the crowd at Augusta.
And there is the scrum start.
Midlife Crash is kind of stepping through the pack gingerly. He still seems to be bound up in some manner of Cuban conflagration.
Omaha doing a solid job on Killbox, but she comes through with a nice juke move. She's out. Killbox, lead jammer for Texas. Midlife Crash is meanwhile still in the back of the pack. Being forced to the out of bounds. Oh, she comes through on the inside. But Barbara Ambush is there to meet her as Killbox with an apex jump. Did she get it? Yep, all 5 points.
Killbox has done three ridiculously sick maneuvers thus far this game. That I've seen, and I've got bad eyes and I'm not very observant. I'm frightened. I'm legitimately frightened, Kool-Aid.
Oh, and Killbox comes through, pushes her way through. No back block called correctly by the referees as she was contacting arms and elbow. She's up and around on the outside. Gets past Mykilla, and she's out for another 5 points.
Omaha was game. They're hitting everything that moves out there. You cannot say that.
All right. Penalty box is empty for Texas. Three blockers out there for Omaha right now. Here comes another scoring pass by Killbox.
And she's out and through, and I see five fingers. That is another 5 points.
Midlife Crashes. Still working on her initial pass. Looks like the inside line was briefly open, but Texas was able to close it before Midlife Crashes able to get out. You can see fatigue starting to come into play here as Killbox, again, just playing offense all by herself. Got a minor back block, but still out for 5 points. Remember, she got the point before the – or got the – point passed correctly after the minor was committed.
Smarty Pants using those legendary pans to positionally block just about everybody. It's like a one-person traffic jam, and that's another 5 points for Texas.
Killbox adding to her point total. 3 seconds left in this jam. Killbox goes through quickly. Looked like she was trying to get at least one more. That was 2 minutes for Midlife Crashes without ever clearing the pack. That's got to be demoralizing.
How many minutes do you think it felt like?
Probably a great deal more than two. You have to give some degree of credit, though, to Omaha. They kept trying, even though you could see the fatigue. Midlife Crashes didn't pass the star off, kept pushing, but the Texas defense just too good as she was unable to get out. All right, we've got Rady Ruck coming back to the jammer line for Omaha. I've not seen her in this second half, and through quickly on the inside line. Molotov impaled, lead jammer for Texas.
You know you're through quickly on the inside line if you are actually out and through before the announcer could even begin to say your name.
So Molotov now comes towards the pack. Oh, nice move. Comes inside to outside and out for 5 points. Rady Ruck, meanwhile, in the back. That is Smarty Pants and Desecration working on Rady Ruck. As here comes Molotov.
Molotov impale trying to get through in the center of the pack right now. But Rady Ruck, she is through. She is on her scoring pass.
Nice little whip there by Omaha. The assist helps Rady Ruck clear the pass. But another scoring pass for Molotov, who calls it off. 5 points there. Even though Rady Ruck was out of the pack, Molotov had already gotten the jammer lap point. So with 20 minutes left, 2:32 for Texas in the black, 27 for Omaha in the white.
And speaking of Omaha in the white, back on the jammer line once again for the 10th time today. If that can be believed, that is number 53, I'm a fire starter. She is going up against number, I can't see the number.
That is Olivia Shootin' John versus I'm a Fire Starter.
I should have been able to figure that one out by context clues.
And Olivia Shootin' John is lead jammer for Texas. I'm a Fire Starter working her way in the back of the pack, gets towards the front. The Texas defense joins her there. The inside line is open, though. I'm a Fire Starter with a nice move. She's out of the pack. Here comes OJ now on a scoring pass.
She's darting back and forth like a snail darter, but in a less endangered manner. She goes out on turn two, calls it off, receives her full complement of 4 points. And the cycle of humanity continues. 236 to 27 is your score. 19 minutes flat left in the second period. Back on that jammer line for the Omaha Roller Girls in the white. That is number 964. That's Ben Eblastigirl every single time I checked. She's going up against number 1853 for Texas. That is a vicious Abana Go Go.
Number 5 here on the first day.
The Blast Girl, the most sparkly member of the Omaha Roller Girls, a title that she champions and holds proudly.
And Vicious Van Gogh with a nice move out of the pack. Not Lee Jammer, though. Minor track cut as she came through. Means the Blaster Girl is still eligible for Lee Jammer status, but here is a Jammer lap point and out for Vicious Van Gogh. Oh, 5 points.
The Blaster Girl's got to be thinking she's got to get through in order to keep this scoring to single digits. It does not look like it may happen. It looks like, Vicious Van Gogh topples and is toppled upon by number 665. That is Daisy Mayhem.
Daisy Mayhem's had a solid effort out there as blocker for Omaha. Vicious stops to tie her skate.
And it looks like we've got a minor track cut on a major track cut on Eblastigirl.
Fourth minor, you were correct. It was a minor, but it was her fourth minor. So Eblastigirl sits down wearing the Jammer Star for Omaha. Vicious Van Gogh with her freshly tied skates is out. Pauses again to tie her skates. Some people might call off the jam to take care of that, but Vicious says, no,
you know, things are rolling your way when you've got time to tie your skates, you know, and in play.
Oh, beautiful apex jump. Did she stick it? She did.
Even the Soviet judge gave that one a 10.
Omaha had a beautiful wall lined up, four across, but Vicious was able to just come through. Texas now does spring one blocker forward to break up the Omaha wall. Pack gets way spread out. And that's another 5-point grand slam for Vicious.
Omaha had a real nice wall built. The problem was they had it built in a place where it was not completely defensible to apex jumps and other sort of aerial attacks of that nature.
And Vicious comes around another grand slam.
And this jam's going to run out on time. 16:39 to go in the ball game. We have got 261 for Texas. We've got 27 for Omaha. If nothing else, at least 27 is 3-cubed.
And it's time for you to go to IronDollClothing.com to check out IronDoll Clothing, custom uniforms for the modern roller derby girl and referee. Lifting and separating since 2009, IronDoll Clothing. And, of course, we want to thank 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Check out the Bracket Bonanza sponsor, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. You can take 10% off your entire order at 2n1skateshop.com when you use the coupon code Bonanza during checkout. 2-in-1 Skate Shop, shock the competition.
Austin, Joe, and Adam, though. 19, Molotov MPL, lead jammer for the Texas Roller Girls.
You know, speaking of that bracket competition, Norb, we had over 500 entrants in the South Central Bracket Competition as part of WFTDA's Bracket Bonanza. Only 64 perfect brackets coming into this game, so after four games, already 400-some-odd folks failed to guess a game correctly. Remember, the winner of the Bracket Bonanza will be looking for this, the South Central Bracket, will be looking for a Jammer Up board game as well as a set of DVDs from all the games.
None can ask better than that, and the fact that you said 64 allows me to throw in another Beatles reference of when I'm 64. That is another grand slam for Molotov MPL, and the points just keep trickling from the sky as if by magic for the Texas Roller Girls. However,
a Blastigirl does get out of the pack.
And a Blastigirl looking to, that is going to necessitate that trip to the floor. Dupa first is going to necessitate a jam call off. That's going to end the scoring.
That was a solid hit there by number 402. Make it rain for Omaha. Forced Molotov to call it off as she took what looked to be a rather painful spill square onto her backside on this somewhat unforgiving concrete floor.
I certainly hope she was wearing those wacky padded butt shorts things, because That could leave a mark.
All right, Killbox comes back to the jammer line for Texas. Animaniac, and we've got a jammer star pass quickly to 33. Loose Bandit, but out for lead jammer is Animaniac.
Well, how about that? Oh, and she's around on the inside. She's got one to beat. She has beat her.
And Animaniac calls it off. Loose Bandit going to the penalty box for a major back block. So the jam was called. And I would suspect that was a premature call off as Loose Bandit was... That jammer star pass was dangling a little precipitously from her helmet. Be that as it may, though, Norb, big advantage here for Omaha coming in. They're going to have an entire minute of power jam to start off this jam.
Not only that, but I believe the referees have conferred and decided that Omaha is going to get the full five points for that pass. And it looks like they're going to be conferring on some more stuff. Our score right now is going to be 266 for Texas, 32 for Omaha, 13:51 to go.
Picking up the, looks like Omaha again would have picked up that fifth jammer point if the Texas jammer, Loose Bandit, had gone to the penalty box, was out of play on her way to the box. When the Omaha jammer passed the blocker, therefore she gets all the out of play points, the ghost points, if you will, which is how she's able to get that grand slam.
That's fascinating how that works.
Speaking of working, if you don't have a job but you still want to go to Champs next year, if you're the grand prize winner of the Bracket Bonanza, you're going to get a trip to the 2013 Champs courtesy of Union Vacations. So be sure to check them out at unionvacations.com and give a big thanks, and we'd like to thank them for providing us with a free airfare and hotel to the 2013 Champs, wherever those Champs might be.
Wherever. Texas is sending a jammer, Olivia Shootin' John, out to stand by the jammer line. And people are losing their heads over the South Central Regionals. Landlocked lace-up, still room for you, folks.
I believe that was Bruiser and Track Rat, yep. Being kissed by Jade Lightning of the Kansas City Roller Warriors Wolfpack. We'll see Kansas skating next at 8 o'clock.
I believe you just called Kansas City, Kansas, and you're going to be slapped up by somebody sitting to your direct left.
That's very possible.
Oh, my God.
Kansas City Roller Warriors will be skating against the Atlanta Roller Girls right here on WFTDA.TV.
And it's going to be great. They're going to be going up against the home team, the No Coast folks.
You know, No Coast is an interesting team. We've seen them in 2010 right here lose to Texas in rather decided fashion in this same round game. Came back to win fifth place. Didn't do so well last year, but I'll be very curious to see how they skate on their home track. I suspect this center, the Pershing Arena, will be quite full of their fans. They tend to pack them out in droves for their games, particularly an 8 p.m. Friday game. I think we'll see a lot of folks out here cheering
on the
home team.
One interesting thing about No Coast is that they have always finished a tournament in a higher position than they have actually been seeded. So I don't know if that just means they excel at tournament time or if everybody else is just a yahoo and they can't get the seedings right. Anyway, it looks like Texas is not going to have a jam.
Texas tried to challenge the back block major.
So Texas called a timeout there to challenge the back block major to Loose Bandit. And to very few people's surprise, the call was not overturned. So Omaha again is going to start off on the power jam. Texas only one blocker on the track. That's 222 desecration. Looks like Centerfold is standing in the penalty box. Two blockers and a jammer for Texas. Omaha with three blockers out there. So
get while the getting's good.
Absolutely. One-on-one action. I'm a fire starter. No pack out of play. Forces I'm a fire starter to be released. She's through for lead jammer.
She's got two Texas Roller Girls to pass right now, and they are worth a grand total of 5 points.
Texas walls up, but again, no pack is called. Forces her to be released.
Let's say it like we mean it. That is a grand slam for I'm a Fire Starter and the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars.
Oh, and just like that, I'm a Fire Starter through for another 5 point grand slam.
Shades of what's his name.
It's nice to give some love to the teams when they get some good points. I'm a fire starter, really showing some effort out there. She gets through another grand slam. That's 15 points now in this jam for Omaha. The team very appreciative of this effort.
takes two to tango, but apparently it takes more than two Texas Roller Girls to adequately contain the force of nature that is I'm a fire starter. She is through for another grand slam. That is a 15-point jam for the Omaha Roller Girls, and everybody is happy as heck. No, excuse me, a 20-point jam.
That was four grand slams there for I'm a fire starter. And borrowing a page from Texas, called off the jam as Loose Bandit, wearing the Jammer Star for Texas, was standing. So Omaha is going to have another opportunity here to start this jam off with a power jam. Looks like we're going to be two on two, a micro pack, each team with two blockers in the track.
266 to 52 is our score. 12:49 is our time.
So Animaniac, who we've seen do some amazing things in their opening round game this morning against Tallahassee. Animaniac, absolutely one of the superstars for the Omaha Roller Girls. She's definitely got the legs. She's got the endurance. We'll see if she can get through. Again, Texas did call a timeout. One remaining for them. 266 for Texas. 52 for Omaha. 12 minutes, 49 seconds left in the game.
And I don't think we can discount the psychological importance of that last jam for Omaha. 266 to 52 looks a heck of a lot better than 266 to 32.
Absolutely.
Even though
absolutely.
32 is 2 to the 5th power.
That is true as well. Absolutely. Looks like we're about to get underway, waiting for the 5 second signal from the official timekeeper.
There are big cardboard cutouts of humans and body parts everywhere in this building. I'd be unnerved if I wasn't just so tickled by the concept.
There's 5 seconds. There's the jam. No pack is called. Animaniac comes through. Oh, nice. Around on the outside. Animaniac lead jammer for Omaha. Penalty box starts to empty out as the power jam is over. Loose Bandit on her first pass. Animaniac on a scoring pass. She's around. And calling off the jam is Animaniac. Only 4 points, but smiles on the face of the Omaha Roller Girls. It's a big cheers from the fans. That was a really nice two-jam sequence for the Omaha Roller Girls there, Norb.
I can't imagine they'd be kicking that one out of bed. 266 to 56 is our score currently. 12:13 is our time. And our jammer shall be number 964 for the Omaha Roller Girls. That is the Plastic Girl. I think that's going up against Texas's 03. That is Olivia Shootin' John. Tell me if I'm wrong.
You are correct.
Good. Another shooting John is able to put a little bit of a jammer nudge on Elastic Girl that I think would prevent her from getting lead jammer, but it does not matter. Mox Nix, as the old folks say, Olivia Shooting John is your lead jammer for the Texas Roller Girls.
So both jammers now out. Very quick moving pack. OJ around inside to outside, calls it off. Get a nice move. She got all her points there by herself. And you can score points for your league, your business, by becoming a WFTDA.TV sponsor. Talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.TV. Affordable packages are available for your business, your boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsor/opportunities to learn more. Become a WFTDA.TV sponsor.
I'm a fire starter who has scored 34 of Omaha's 56 points is taking the jammer line for Omaha. Killbox, number 989, is taking the jammer line for Texas, and she is getting knocked to the inside by Makilia of the Omaha Roller Girls. That is going to set up Omaha pretty well, and yes, she is through. It is I'm a fire starter, your lead jammer for the Omaha Roller Girls. However, Killbox hot on her heels, the tail of the 10th.
Killbox very quick, trying to get positional advantage on I'm a fire starter. Nice to see the jammers engage, coming towards the pack, and with a nice juke move, Omaha had all three of their blockers in the back, and I'm a fire starter, calls it off. I think a smart play there is there was very low probability of coming out of that jam with a points advantage with the way the pack was set up. And really nice to see Killbox and I'm a fire starter give each other a little pat on the back as they skate towards their respective benches.
I'm all for patting. It's a good thing. Keep up the good work. Back on that jammer line for Omaha, that is number 999, Animaniac. She is going up against number 19 for the Texas Roller Girls. That is Molotov Impale.
270 to 56, 10 minutes left in the game. Molotov looks for an inside line. Animaniac looks for the outside. Both jammers up front, and your lead jammer is Animaniac. Molotov Impale, though, the jammer in the lead. But Animaniac looks like she's trying to get in front of Molotov, and she's going to do it. Nice move by Animaniacs. Barely got the speed advantage on Molotov. Now she comes into the Texas defense. Calls it off. No points for Texas. No points for Omaha. That was a solid, solid jam by Animaniac.
That was almost NASCAR-like in its, you know, positional. Not that I'm qualified to speak, you know, brilliantly about racing.
She did draft behind Molotov and Pails. They came into the turn, scooted to the outside, was able to cut around her. Really nice little exhibition of skating there by Animaniac.
So say we all.
Opa! We got Rady Ruck versus Livia Shootin' John.
Livia Shootin' John is zigzagging back and forth. Livia Shootin' John. She's got one to beat. She's got zero to beat. She is your lead jammer for the Dexecutioners.
Rady Ruck now in the back. Pack moving moderately as we come around to turn four. Here comes OJ on a scoring pass. There's the jammer. Lap point. Gets past Mike Killa. 5 points of a pentapass.
And it looks like Omaha traded one blocker in for another. They have three on the track.
Rady Ruck just trying to get through this Texas three wall up front, not having much luck. OJ with another 5 points for Texas. Pack starts to pick up a little bit of speed. Rady Ruck comes into turn three with the Texas defense. Omaha is in the back. Oh, they don't even see OJ. She comes through untouched. That's another 5 points for Texas.
Yeah, I don't think Rady Ruck is going to get through that two wall of Texas if she does not get some blocker help up there. They have got her number.
They absolutely do. Omaha does, almost reading our mind, comes forward to play a little bit of offense, but now OJ comes into the pack. They quickly switch back to defense, which means Rady Ruck is again all by herself in the back.
All by herself like Eric Carmen.
OJ gets another grand slam. Omaha does a good job of switching to offense, but just not able to spring Rady Ruck. Here comes OJ on yet another scoring run.
Rady Ruck briefly with one Texecutioner to beat. Now she is back with one to beat, but she is driven into the infield on turn one. She's going to head to the back of the bus, start that whole arduous process over again.
And time enough for one more scoring pass. OJ gets through, gets around, another grand slam. And with that, I believe OJ has moved into the front of the race for scoring champion for Texas for this bout. 7 minutes left in the game, 300. Texas has hit the tri-century mark, 56 for Omaha.
Well, that's a nice even number, if nothing else. Back on the jammer line for Texas, we've got number 989. That is, of course, Killbox. She is going up against number 53 for the Omaha Roller Girls. Believe it or don't, that's I'm a fire starter.
Omaha sprints forward towards the pivot line. Everyone's standing, but no pack to begin. Nice. And Killbox is up and around. Lead jammer, Killbox for Texas. Same song, different verses. The Texas defense doing a solid job on I'm a Fire Starter.
Desi Creation really doing a nice job on I'm a Fire Starter in specific. And just as if on cue, she knocks her to the out of bounds area on turn one.
Meanwhile, Killbox catches up, scoring pants. Nice. Killbox paused for a minute, waited for the defense to sort of get set, and then came around on the outside. 5 points on that pass. I'm a Fire Starter, taken down courtesy of Shortcut. Killbox attempted the apex jump, was knocked out of bounds, managed to avoid re-entering, avoids a track cut. She's back to it. Meanwhile, I'm a Fire Starter is out of the pack.
And that was a nice hit by Make It Rain, number 402 for Omaha in the white. She finally found a way to thwart one of those crazy aerial acrobatic maneuvers by Killbox.
Make It Rain's had more than one solid hit here playing defense for Omaha.
Looks like Molotov and Bale will be taking an intentional fourth minor unless she simply is trying to jam without a helmet covering.
Jamming with a helmet cover is Vicious Fangogo for Texas against a Blastigirl for Omaha. Texas right now with three blockers on the track, three for Omaha. Oh, and Vicious right through in the middle before they even got halfway to the pivot line is out for lead jammer. A Blastigirl tries to get by Smarty Pants, can't do it. They both go out of bounds, both back in. Here comes Vicious.
And Vicious has secured that jammer lap point to the best of my ability. She has also passed everyone else. That is a grand slam for Vicious Vangogo of the Dexecutioners.
A Blaster Girl does get out of the pack. So Vicious likely one more scoring pass here. What she does, checks Elastigirl, checks her bench. They're telling her to keep going, so she's going to keep going.
Might as well, can't dance.
And out front is Elastigirl, but she gets out. All 4 points. So the Jammers trade points on that last pass. Vicious Van Gogh looks to finish this pass. She does, but does not call it. So Elastigirl on another scoring run of her own, Norb.
I think at this point in time, Texas realizes they have pretty much all the points they need. And at this point in time, they're just going to kill clock. And
well, and also empty the, more to the point, empty to the penalty box.
Yeah, that works too. Yeah, but be that as it may, 4 more points for the Omaha Roller Girls.
I suspect that's truly was the ultimate goal there, was not so much to kill the clock, but to kill the penalty clock, as Texas now able to field, I believe, 3 blockers. Do they have 2? Well, in the process of killing penalty clock, they racked up some more penalty time. So it's going to be 4 blockers to 2. Pack advantage for Omaha over Texas. 326-64 with 3.5 minutes left. We've got Animaniac jamming 4. Omaha and Olivia Shooting John for Texas, and we've got a timeout.
It was just mere seconds ago that Omaha had 2 to the 5th power with 32 points. Now they got 2 to the 6th power with 64 points. They have impressed and increased their whatever you call it when it's not a lead, by an order of magnitude.
Somewhere north, there is a math teacher who's very happy with you, and
I don't think so.
The rest of us are all going, huh?
Well, keep up the good work.
And if you're a math teacher and want to correct math, Norv on his math, you can do it on the Twitter feed. Talk to the number 2, WFTDA. We'd love to hear from you. Any shout-outs? We've got watch parties in South Africa as well as Austin, Texas. A great many folks watching all the action right here on WFTDA.TV. If things hold, Texas will play Tampa tomorrow at 2 p.m., and Omaha will play the winner of Jacksonville versus Nashville at 6 p.m. tonight. Tomorrow. Excuse me, tomorrow. I forgot what day it was. So much roller derby. Gets so exciting.
I forgot if it was today or tomorrow.
One more game tonight. So tomorrow at 2 p.m., if things hold, will be Texas versus Tampa and Omaha versus Jackson or Nashville. Again, Omaha assured of no worse than an 8th-place finish. And we've seen more than one team, after getting thrashed by the number 1 seed in these regionals, come back and take 5th place. So you think that has to be their ultimate goal for the weekend?
Well, I think people really underestimate the psychological importance of, you know, taking 5th place. If you take 5th place, yes, you're not competing for anything. You're not competing for a trip to championships. You're essentially competing for a number by your name and so on and so forth. But if you get 5th place, you're 1 away from 4th place. And if you got 4th place, that means you have been competing for a trip to championships on Sunday. That's what 5th place means to me. On the Jammer line, after that lovely award-winning essay by me, that's number 999 for the Omaha Roller Girls All-Stars. That is Animaniac. She's going up against number 03. That's Olivia Shooting John for the Texecutioners.
All right, that official timeout was Omaha challenging 2 of the points that were scored on one of the last scoring passes by Texas, but the point stand, the call was correct according to the referees who made the call. Another scrum start to begin with, and another lead jammer for Olivia Shooting John as that inside line was wide open. Animaniac, though, with a nice move. Also, the inside door was opened by Texas. It's hard to keep the door closed with only 2 blockers out there. So both jammers out. Here comes OJ. Outside to inside. Animaniac now on a scoring run of her own.
Those 2 blockers doing not a half bad job on the jammer for the Omaha Roller Girls, number 999, Animaniac.
That was Desecration with a solid hit on Animaniac, who now does get out. That was 4 points. Again, looks like OJ's not calling it off, trying to run some penalty clock here, or possibly just run some clock. The bench tells her to keep going.
And back at a standstill, be calm, little pushing, little rolling. Getting about first or possibly second gear right now. Nice 1-2, sometimes 3 wall by Omaha.
OJ makes her way towards the front, does get out. Well, Animaniac skating somewhat slowly towards that pack. I don't know if it's fatigue or just not thrilled about engaging this Texas defense. Yeah, you can definitely see the fatigue starting to take hold here, Norb.
Well, luckily we have reached the 2-minute warning, and she won't have to worry about that for long. Until tomorrow.
Both jammers trying to work their way through the pack. Any Maniac just skating in the back.
Yeah, I think.
And a solid hit.
Can actually run on fumes.
Well, Daisy Mayhem had a little bit something left in the tank as she was able to knock Olivia Shootin-John outside and out of bounds. And OJ said, that's enough of that.
Daisy Mayhem getting her money's worth tonight.
Absolutely.
Back on that jammer line for the Texecutioners. That's number 989. Now that is a kill box. She's going up against Huda Thunkett, number 53 for the Omaha Roller Girls. I'm a fire starter. It is possible this is the fire jam, final jam of the game. But we wouldn't bet on it because we're good boys and wouldn't do such things. Texas.
But if you didn't want to bet on it, you could probably go to WFTDA.com and look for the Bracket Bonanza, which is a form of gambling, except you're not going to make any money. You're just going to win DVDs, jammer up video games, and potentially a trip to championships next year. So check it out at WFTDA.com and look for the Bracket Bonanza instructions and get your picks in. And it's not too late to play for champs and to play for some DVDs and a jammer up board game.
In Norb's perfect world, swag is the universal currency.
And Killbox universal currency is Grand Slams, and she gets another one there. Runs the score up to 348-72.
And it looks like she is not quite finished. She is going to feast on the bounty of points set before her. Emma Fire Charter is out.
And going to the penalty box for a major. Was it a fourth minor track cut? Fourth minor track cut. So with 13 seconds left in the game, I suspect we'll see Killbox run out the clock and then call it off. Maybe she can get herself a jammer up board game when it's all said and done. That's the game clock, so this will be the last jam. Killbox not calling it off. Looks like she wants some more points.
Looks like Killbox is also wanting to get her money's worth. She is letting this thing continue, although calling the jam right now would seal the victory. But what the heck?
And
shifty.
Texas is
shifty.
Continuing to run this score up. And of course, we are now to the jam clock only. I know why. I just am not sure if I'm allowed to say it or not. And there's an apex jump. Killbox avoids the track cut as she did not re-enter inbounds or upright in skating when she came from out of bounds to inbounds.
Yeah, I think that is going to flat get it as far as the scoring goes. 371 for Texas, 72 for Omaha is going to be oh, my goodness. Maybe I spake too soon.
And the jam ends with a solid hit by Sharon Misery. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the game. Final score, 374 for Texas, 72 for Omaha.
I think those last 3 points cost a little bit more in terms of physical agony than Killbox was imagining they would.
Well, if anyone can take a hit out there, it is Killbox.
So 375-72 is our unofficial final score in favor of Texas.
My name is Chip Queso, and I am joined here by the fabulous Bell Star from the Texecutioners here at the South Central Regionals here in Lincoln, Nebraska. And, of course, they just came off a win of 375-72 over Omaha. Now, Bell Star, great bout for Texas, starting out the way that you want, but the job is not over. You've been here before, and you know you have a long way to go. What are your thoughts on that?
We're just taking it one day at a time. If we didn't win this game, we weren't eligible to qualify for Championals. So we had to win this one and get through it. Now we're going to talk about our second game and, you know, go home and get some rest and come back ready to do our thing tomorrow.
Absolutely. Now, Texas is always very seriously, not a lot of time to bask in the win. You're going to immediately go back and work on what the next challenge is. At the same time, the team's a little bit different. We've got some new faces and all that. But tell me a little bit about the chemistry, how things are going with the team as a whole.
I mean, we just, again, one day at a time. Like, I'm just going to use that as an answer for everything. We're just, you know, every time we bring on a new skater, I mean, of course, they've been around Derby and they're exposed to it. And then we try and train them into our team think and get them going with exactly what we need them to do to be on our page and, you know, just go from there one day at a time.
Yeah. Now, Bell Star, you're known for being loose out on the track, doing some dance moves and that sort of thing. And I think that helps the team. A lot of serious faces and you keep it loose. Just part of your style. That's the way you are, right?
Yeah, no, that's actually my serious face. If I have a serious face, I'm probably not paying attention, and so you probably need to be worried. So that's how I put on my serious face. And yeah, I think it's think it works.
There you go. And lastly, you have some fans here that have driven in to join and enjoy the event, but they're a little special to you. Who are your fans? And let people know it's special.
Well, there are a couple of our Austin Derby brats who drove all the way from Austin, Texas to Lincoln, Nebraska to be here. Sweet and Sour and Live and Let Die, and their parents, who are also big Derby fans, came all the way up to support us and got a special place in my heart.
It's a beautiful thing. Well, we all have a special place for what's going on here. Great win for Texas.